To lose your job is a kick in the teeth, especially when you've done a good job and it's just a matter of the economy. And the big thing, I think, is to stay positive. Because when you lose your job, you lose part of your identity. And the reality is what makes you valuable is still the same today than it was yesterday. So focusing on making it about them when you move in and go to that job interview, because you tend to be focused on your life, but in reality the employer is interested in what you can bring to the table.
Right, exactly. Yeah. And now, you know, we talk about preparing for interviews. Do you write these things down? Do you memorize them? Or is it really just about a conversation between you and your possible boss?
Well, you have a plan, an outline. You certainly wouldn't want to write it, script it completely. But a lot of it is about, as I said, making it about them and show them how you can help. In other words, research the company and decide, decipher what it is A, B, and C that they need. And then you have to be prepared to tell them how you can deliver A, B, and C. And tell them in a way which speaks to the accomplishments that you have. Because oftentimes I see resumes and they list duties. I was this, I did that, and that doesn't tell me anything. Tell me what you've accomplished. Because from an employer standpoint, I'm looking for somebody who can help me, but I want them to tell me how they have already done something so I have more assurance that they really can help me.
You talk about that resume being so important, especially if you haven't polished it up for a while. That
right.
might take a little while. An easy to read resume that is clarity, not quantity. Talk about that.
Absolutely. Employers, especially today, they're getting dozens and dozens of resumes on their desk, and frankly, most of them don't get read. When I see a stack of resumes, I'm zipping through them. If it looks like it's a lot of text and it's hard to read, it's less likely to get a good look. So use some white space, bold headlines, and talk about, boil it down to the things that you really do well and that you bring to the table. And alter the resume to every job that you're applying for, because every job is different. Oftentimes, they start out with an objective, mm-hmm. which I don't like at all, because your objective is always the same. To get the job you're interviewing for.
Right.
You should really start out with a summary and says, hey, this is what I bring to the table. Even if you read only a sentence or two of this resume, the sentence or two is about what I bring to the table and how I can help you.
This next one I think is so important, listening well, because sometimes we're just so wrapped up in
yep.
how do I look, what am I going to say next,
right.
and then,
yeah.
oh my gosh, what did this person just say?
Exactly. We're so focused on ourselves, and what am I going to wear, you're right, and am I doing the right thing, and it's obviously understandable. Be a little self-conscious, but really it's about them. You can say, hey, explain to them, I think I really understand what you want and what you need, and I think I can deliver that. And by the way, here are the things that I've done in the past that give evidence that support my conclusion. If you can have evidence as opposed to a claim, then you're going to have a stronger case with your prospective employer.
And your final tip here is follow-up. I mean, definitely, do you suggest sending a thank you card, making a call?
Why not? Thank you card is it shows that you're engaged in the interview, you're still interested. Say something in the thank you card that speaks to a highlight of the interview. You said, you know, we talked a lot about X, and I'm really interested in X, and I've got a lot of experience in X. When we talk about listening well, you can pick up from them what they're really looking for. That's the key. If you can find out what they're really looking for, then you're better able to say, I can deliver that, and in a way than better than all the other applicants. And I think, you know, you've got evidence. But stay positive too, Jessica.
And shows that you were engaged in that interview.
Absolutely.
As well. Great to have you here this morning.
Well, good luck to everyone out there. You can do it.